Auburn Blitz is now on the air. Your daily look into what's happening in Auburn athletics. With your host, Andy Graham, Brett Pritchard, Randy Lee, War Eagle.
Hello, everybody, and good Friday to you, and welcome into the Auburn Blitz. Brett and Scott here with you for your lunch hour, and we're glad that you joined us out there as the rain moves into Alabama. It's going to be a rainy Friday, but we hope it's a bright and sunny day up in Spokane. Well, I don't know what the weather is. It's probably gloomy. It always is
in Washington.
So maybe that's the irony here. We're kind of getting the same weather that they're probably experiencing up there. But anyway, we're going to talk about the big matchup today. Auburn will take the floor at 3:15 Central Time to take on the Yale Bulldogs. We'll talk more about that. Auburn actually played Yale back in 21-22,
right,
if you remember.
Right.
So the one meeting there between those two teams. So we'll talk about that and a lot more here. Our program brought to you by Russell Do It Center and Building Supply Stores, J.A. Smith Construction and Excavation, and Central Alabama Community College. All of you out there, we could not do it without those three great corporate partners, and been part of the show for a long time and glad to have them here. You know, Scott, good to see you. It's been a minute since you kind of had some issues a little bit. We'll dive all into that. But
I was supposed to be here last week, and I didn't make it.
I had a joke, but I'll say.
Go ahead on.
No, I was going to say, you just forgot how to get here.
I did.
So it's that simple, right?
Yeah.
No, but glad you're back. You know, that was a little bit of a scary moment, but you got a chance to – you were actually watching the show last Friday from the hospital.
I was.
You commented.
From Grandview Hospital.
Well, we're glad you're here now and not over there anymore. Scott, yesterday, March Madness, it reared its ugly head early.
Oh, my gosh.
The SEC did not play well. Tennessee beat – it was a runaway, but South Carolina, Mississippi State, and the story is Kentucky still. And I said this a few weeks ago about John Calipari, and I said nobody's done less with more than he has. And I think his buyout's $90 million. I think it's somewhere around there.
I read 34 this morning.
Maybe originally it was 90.
Because he signed a lifetime contract.
He signed a lifetime contract.
In 19, and then we beat him, and he ain't done squat since.
Well, you know, we beat him in the tournament.
I know.
In the Elite Eight.
Mm-hmm.
And really, since then, you're right. I mean, they haven't done – now, they won the regular season in 20.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we were going to win the tournament in 20. We were playing the best basketball, but, you know, COVID hit and all that.
Right.
But since then, he's 1-4 in NCAA tournament games. He's missed the tournament. He's lost in the first round a couple of times now.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, look, the kid from Oakland was unconscious. You know – here's the irony behind this. If Auburn gets the 3 seed, that was us last night playing Oakland.
I know it. I'm not so sure.
Sometimes be leery of what you ask for. You might have got – so Kentucky was like, we got the 3 seed. Well, there's your gift.
How do you pronounce it? Golki.
You're talking about Golki, the guy that was making all the three?
Yeah.
He was one shy of the record.
Yeah.
And he had 10.
He's taken 347 threes this season. So he's only taken 10 – or no, 8 or 10 two-point shots. The whole season.
All he does is shoot threes.
Shoot threes. Like me at lunch ball years ago.
Guess what? Yeah. If you want to be good at one phase of the game, why not get an extra point for
it? He light it up.
But he made some shots last night. You know, the little catch and running off balance, fading away to the side.
Falling back.
Yeah, you know, not even really falling back, falling to the side, which is really hard to do.
Yeah.
But, you know, made some really tough shots there. I kind of felt like Kentucky in the first 5 minutes of the second half – would determine if this thing was going to be a rock fight coming down or would they take control.
Mm-hmm.
And, man, the announcer said it. Every minute that goes by in this game, it gets harder for Kentucky to come back. And I don't know what happened to Shepherd last night. He played scared.
He did. He was not the same guy that played 2 weeks before the tournament and he was beating everybody. He was just on fire.
He had a couple games where he won the game for Kentucky this year.
Yeah.
Had a couple 30-point games. He would not even shoot the basketball. Mm-hmm. And so I think he had 2 shots in the first half, finally made a 3 there with about 10 minutes to go in the second half. And you thought, here he goes. Never shot it again, really.
Right.
So
they just couldn't they couldn't. They'd get up a point or two.
Right.
And then Golkey would go hit a three, or somebody hit a three for them, and it would be back on again.
Well,
they couldn't get over that 4 or 5 point deficit the entire game. A
couple games going on right now. Baylor over Colgate 29-19, and Northwestern leading FAU by a point 19-18. But going back to yesterday, you know, you look at these matchups and kind of run it down. Mississippi State, Michigan State got it started. Man, I tell you, and Michigan State got off to a fast start, and they never looked back. Mississippi State really was fighting uphill the whole time.
Mm-hmm.
Thought Hubbard would be a – and when I picked Mississippi State for my bracket, I thought Hubbard would be a difference maker. He's been a difference maker for them. And I look for guys like Golkey to kind of take a game over an NCAA tournament, have 25.
Right.
Well, Hubbard's capable of doing that.
Yeah.
But he didn't do much yesterday.
He
and then
didn't get it going.
And so, you know, and Auburn shut him down. You know, Auburn kind of kept him in tempo. He started making shots
toward the end of the game.
Toward the end of the game, but he had been quiet for most of the game.
He's got a pretty shot.
But I thought he would probably be the difference, because I've watched Michigan State this year, and they've been a very subpar team.
Right.
You know, they were worthy of a 9 seed.
But they are Michigan State.
They are Michigan State.
You get the tournament.
Right.
And they
that is how many years in a row now for Michigan State? 25 years making the NCAA
something
tournament.
Like that. Yeah.
That's unbelievable. That's hard to do.
Mm-hmm.
Duquesne were gifted free shoes from our new shoes by LeBron James. I guess they worked. They knocked off BYU 71-67.
Mm-hmm.
Creighton is a team you better watch. They're a 3 seed. I know they played Akron, but this team, a lot of people have them going, you know, maybe all the way to the Final Four, depending on how they play. But Creighton is definitely a strong suit. Arizona struggled for a while with Long Beach State, but ended up winning the game by 20, 85-65. North Carolina looked really good over a much overmatched Wagner team.
Oh, yeah.
Couldn't really tell anything from that, but they did what you're supposed to do as a 1 seed. They came out. They came out and took care of business. You know, if Auburn had gotten a 3 seed in the East region, it would have been them and Morehead State. Illinois knocked off Morehead State 85-69. That was Jani Broome's old school.
Yep.
Morehead State. That would have been a good storyline.
It would have been a great story.
But then South Carolina hits a half-court shot to cut it to 4 to at halftime, but it wasn't enough. Oregon pulled away in that game, an 11 over a 6, 87-73. The Flyers, 3 points better than Nevada. The Today Show had – Nevada in the national, actually in the Final Four, right? So their bracket, but they had us pick to win the national championship. So I hope that's not an omen.
I know.
Anyway, Texas over Colorado State, 56-44. You know, Colorado State had just come off that play-in game, and that's about how we felt like it would work out. Kentucky, once again, Oakland defeats them 80-76. This is 2 out of the last 3 years Kentucky's gone out in the first round. St. Peter's, the team that Tennessee destroyed, is the team that knocked them out 2 years ago.
I know.
And then, you know, again.
So have they ever lost to a 14 seed before? I mean, that's a low seed to beat them out in the first round.
I would say no. I think Kentucky's never lost to a 14.
I wouldn't think so.
Nobody said anything about that, though, last night in all the commentary.
Right.
Gonzaga, you better watch this Gonzaga team. They're they're a 5 seed, but they're playing really good, and they're Gonzaga. And they had no problem with McNeese. There's several people picked them to upset Gonzaga, and it was not close. 86-65, as we said, Tennessee all over St. Peter's, 83-49. NC State had that play-in game, won the ACC tournament, won the ACC tournament in 5 games and knock off a 6 seed Texas Tech, 80-67. Washington State outlasted Drake, 66-61. And last night, we can talk a little bit about this one. Kansas over Samford, 93-89. Kansas extended that lead out to 22.
Mm-hmm.
It looked like Samford was going to get blown out, run out of the gym. And all of a sudden, they're right there with a chance. And then a breakaway dunk, and Samford gets back. Clean. We've seen the steal shots.
Right.
We've seen the slow motion. It was a clean block. There's no other way to spin it. The referee missed it, man.
Mm-hmm.
And it ended up being probably the difference in the game. You know, Samford was still behind, but it was a 1-point game at the time.
Right.
So if that's a clean block and They have to inbound the ball or whatever. You know, you never know what happens, but it goes to the line, makes the shots. And
oh, they got the rebound. If it was clean, they got the rebound.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, Cleans gets a rebound.
Yeah.
It's a whole different thing. But Bucky McMillan, he is a meteoric rise to where he is right now. He was at Mountain Brook just a few years ago, went over to Sanford, and has built a great program. Mm-hmm. Hey, there's going to be some suitors calling on him in all season.
Kentucky may call him.
Well, they may. I don't know. How much money is Kentucky willing to part ways with to get rid of John Calipari? But just kind of your thoughts on Sanford last night. I mean, they stayed the course, man. They put themselves in a position you hate to see. Mm. And I thought Kentucky caught a break against Oakland. There was a time, there was one, it was a loose ball. It looked like it was just a battle. And Oakland got the ball, and then a late whistle gave the ball back to Kentucky, and they ended up hitting a three on that possession.
Right.
And I texted a bunch of people in our group. I said, the referees just gave Kentucky 3 points.
Right.
And that could come back to cost Oakland at the end. You just hate to see referees get involved.
Well, you know, I'm going to be honest with you. During that game, I watched the entire first half of Sanford game. The second half.
You fell asleep.
I fell out. I woke up with like 2 minutes to go.
Well, there you go.
Yeah, and I was like, oh, my gosh, you know, because it was almost midnight. And but it's awful to see a game end that way. But Charles Barkley and Kenny Smith on the show last night, and even Clark Kellogg. Clark wasn't really agreeing with him much, but Chuck and Kenny were saying, you got to have a challenge flag, at least give them 1.5 or something, because they review ticky-tack fouls sometimes. Like, was that flagrant? The guy's elbow went up in the air.
Yeah.
So they review weird stuff, but that right there – That impacted the game tremendously.
Oh, it did. No, it absolutely did.
And it's like in football, step out of bounds or not step out of bounds. Review it, challenge it, and give them one.
If that's the goal of review is to correct plays that impact the game, then why not make that review?
Right. Give them a challenge flag.
Right. You know, referees make mistakes, man. You need to go back and check. Hey, there are review calls in baseball now on an out.
They make mistakes in the first half, and there are awful calls there too.
Yeah.
But when it's that close to the end of the game and it's that tight, that gets everybody's attention, you know.
Up against the first break of the show, stay tuned. Just getting started here on the Auburn Blitz for this Friday.
Hi, this is Brian Bice with Bice Motors. With our all-star lineup of Dodge trucks, Jeep SUVs, and Chrysler cars, we offer the area a team dedicated to making your next vehicle purchase a positive experience. Our sales team offers competitive pricing, and we back up all sales with service department second to none. Bice Motors also offers the area's best selection of pre-owned vehicles. Visit Bice Motors at 2133 Cherokee Road in Alexander City.
Heritage South Credit Union in Alexander City is your community credit union, and they have been for over 80 years. Heritage South Credit Union proudly serves Tallapoosa, Coosa, Lee, Chambers, Randolph, and Chilton counties. From checking to business accounts, to share savings to club accounts, to their kids club and investments, visit them online at myhscu.com. Heritage South Credit Union, your community credit union for 80 years. Federally insured by NCUA.
When you need an automotive hero, you got to call S&S Discount Tire Pros. With locations in Alexander City and Daville, we are here to serve you today. From quick services like oil changes and tire rotations to in-depth automotive repairs such as suspensions, brakes, and tune-ups, S&S can take care of all your tire needs. You just have to focus on what's important and love the drive. Call S&S Discount Tire Pros today. We are automotive heroes, and we are here to serve you.
WOTM is the television provider for all Alabama High School Athletic Association championship events and special programs. WOTM is your home for the Super 7 football, state finals basketball, baseball and softball state championships, the AHSAA weekly show, and WOTM also produced the first ever football playoff show, Super 7 preview show, and reclassification reveal show. Your exclusive home for all things AHSAA is WOTM. Contact your local cable provider to request WOTM to your channel lineup.
Whether it's Lake Martin, Lay Lake, or Logan Martin, boaters from all over the state of Alabama come to Alex City Marine, just off Highway 280 in Alexander City, Alabama, because it's worth the drive. With the best deals on unbeatable Suzuki outboards, Manitou and Landau tritunes, and a great pre-owned inventory while they last. Alex City Marine is the pros the locals know. And no matter where you're from, when you're here, you're local to us. Alex City Marine, just off Highway 280 in Alexander City, Alabama. AlexCityMarine.com.
Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply Stores have the tools and materials to get the job done right, whether you're a professional contractor or just a weekend do-it-yourselfer. With everyday customer conveniences like a drive-through lumber yard, price match promise, and our best rewards program, each of our 9 locations offer top brands and building materials like lumber, hardware, tools, paint, lawn and garden, and much more. Visit today and see what Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply can help you build tomorrow.
Let's get serious. Let's get Arctic Air serious. You want your car and truck to live longer, don't you? Well, it's about maintenance. Same thing with Arctic Air. You see the number at the bottom of the screen? Call them right now. Let me tell you something. You want to be comfortable? We all want to be comfortable.
It's truck season at Glenn Smith Chevrolet in Opelika. Check out the powerful full-size and fully loaded Chevrolet Silverado LTZ, discounted up to $11,000 off, or the roomy midsize three-row SUV, the Chevy Traverse, discounted up to $7,750 off, and the perfect size Chevy Equinox up to $7,750 off. No payments until summertime. Over 350 new and used vehicles on the lot or on the way.
Get ready to smile.
Welcome back, everyone, to the Auburn Blitz here. 45 minutes left in today's show. Brought to you by Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply Stores, J.A. Smith Construction and Excavation, and Central Alabama Community College. Proud sponsors here. It's always fun to talk about the specials at Pepper Tree Steaks and Wine. Scott, if you haven't been down to Auburn on East Glen, you're missing out. If you haven't been to Montgomery, to their place, it's been in business for 25 years, you're missing out. On Fridays and Saturdays, it's always burger and wing special. So after 2 p.m., go buy Pepper Tree Steaks and Wine, and they have it kind of priced out based on how many people you got in your family. They start serving at 2 p.m. So when you get off work, hey, what a perfect day to do. You got basketball on all day today. Now's the time to go do it. Also, this weekend, they have the New York Strip Weekend. Two New York strips, two twice baked potatoes, two rolls, $42.99. Hey, man, pretty doggone good.
That ain't bad.
So head on out to Pepper Tree Steaks and Wine. They'll take care of you. They also have a fish and shrimp fry weekend going on. So they got a lot going on at Pepper Tree Steaks and Wine. I want to thank Kathy and all of her staff. Great place of business. Go check them out in Auburn down there on East Glen. Let's talk about this Yale-Auburn matchup here. This is a Yale team that's got a big guy inside, a seven-footer. They play really good defense. They played in some tough games this year already. They went to Allen Fieldhouse and had a lead against Kansas. Their schedule's been tough. And, I know they did a buzzer beater to beat Brown, and Brown's not very good. But it's March, man. And as you saw last night with Oakland, you don't know when that guy is going to be unconscious for whoever.
It gets hot.
And who's going to be able to you know, be playing above their head, for lack of better terms. But this team only averages about 75 points a game, but they only allow 66. So it's going to be an interesting deal. Let's go to the phone lines for the first time and pick up our caller on the Eric McKinley Mortgage Pro Hotline. What's up?
Hey there. This is Ed calling from Pelham. Is Auburn's basketball team 100% straight?
Is Auburn's basketball team what?
100%. I'm sorry, I had an accident this week. I got run over by a truck. Is Auburn's basketball team 100% healthy today?
Yeah, I think so. I do think they're healthy. I don't know of any injuries. Jalen Williams seems to be 100%. Went through that tournament this past week with really no injuries. Jalen Williams did go down and I think it was that Mississippi State game. It was a little bit scary, but ended up being okay. I think Auburn's 100%. I appreciate you, Ed.
Okay, and what time is the game and what network?
It will be on TNT, 3:15 today.
And is it 12:20 now or 11:20 now?
It's 12:20 Central Time.
Okay, we'll say 3:15 Central Time.
That's it.
That's it.
War Eagle.
Thanks so much, Ed. So, yeah, 3:15 on TNT today. Auburn and Yale. Again, Auburn and Alabama staying in the same hotel. Out in Spokane. So we fly out to Spokane, Washington, and we're all – is UAB in the same hotel too?
I don't know if they're in the same hotel, but they're all right there together. You know, it's amazing.
But anyway, Alabama will take the floor right after our game today, and they play, you know, again, Charleston. I think it should be fairly easy for them. You know, UAB plays they play at 12:45 against San Diego State. So that game will be coming on here in just a few minutes. But going back to this Auburn Yale, this 19 run that Auburn had started with an SEC tournament championship. Mm-hmm. Bruce has already alluded to how important he thinks the tournament was to kind of sparking them to play. Now, if you'll remember, New Mexico State had a shot in the corner to win the game.
We fouled him, and he missed the shot.
I know.
We were sitting at Lulu's watching it at lunch down there.
So I said it on Gary Harris's show this morning. If that goes in or if he makes the shots and we lose, that run never exists.
No.
And nobody remembers anything. That's why you have to take every opponent seriously. Like Bruce said last week, he said, you don't start playing for a national championship when you get to the Final Four. You start when you play your first game.
That's right.
So, Yale, I mean, they're going to play a different style of basketball. Sometimes that can throw you off in your style and how you play.
Well, their big guy, he scores about 20 points a game.
He's 7 feet tall, man. I mean,
and they got a shooter, too. They got some guy that can light it up. And
I
can't remember his name, but they've got two key players. They got a guard and that big center that – or their main two players.
We should outmatch them, obviously.
Yeah, we ought to.
We're a 13.5-point favorite. But, again, you can crumble that up and throw it away.
Well, Kansas should have outmatched Samford.
Well, and they were. I mean, they were up 22, and then all of a sudden you look up and the game's on the line.
Well, there's no way Kansas should have even been close to losing that game.
Like, okay, I want to get this out. All right, Samford, that was a terrible call.
Right.
It may have cost them the game. I'm not going to say it cost them the game because they were still down.
Mm-hmm.
But – it was a blown call, and it definitely impacted the end. I feel sorry for you, Samford fans, but I'll never feel more sorry for anybody than us in 19 when we got two of the absolute worst calls that you could get.
Yeah.
And people can say, well, Samir Dowdy fouled him. Come on, man. Look, he it did not impact the shot. The clock had expired when he shot the ball.
Right.
That game should have been over.
Right.
Instead, you determine a semifinal game on a daggum free throw. Now, I know, hey, look, a foul's a foul. I get all that stuff. But the double dribble was as clear as day.
Oh, yeah.
And if they call that, none of that even happens.
Doesn't have to happen. Yeah.
So, but I know on the flip side, Jared Harper, if he goes down and makes that free throw, we're not even talking about this. But anyway, I hear you, Samford.
It's awful.
Boy, we've been through it. I know what it feels like. We all know what it – people ask all the time – what hurt worse, that Final Four loss or the national championship game against Florida State? They both sucked.
They did.
But I'd almost say because we had of course, we won another football championship. That'd been 2 in 4 years.
Right.
But, man, we were about to win. I think we would be
ever
basketball ever championship.
We'd have won the next game.
There was 1.2 seconds on the clock when Virginia inbounded that basketball, by the way.
I know.
You got to play every second.
That hurt worse than the football game.
I'm going to tell you, I think it did.
It did.
I think the basketball.
Personally, it did because I'm a more of a basketball fan than a football fan, and it just hurt.
But they both sucked.
I know.
I mean, look, choose your poison, man.
Mm-hmm.
All right, up against the break. Stay tuned. Got comments coming in. We'll get to them when we come back. Stay tuned. More to come right after this.
This is Kathy Holmes with Pepper Tree Steaks and Wine. Jeff Verner and I opened in East Montgomery 25 years ago and have become the premier butcher shop, wine retailer, and caterer in the River Region. We are excited to invite you to our newest location at 2459 East Glen Avenue in Auburn, Opelika. We want to become your one-stop shop for the freshest cuts of meat in town, grab-and-go casseroles, gift items, and the best wine selection in the area. Think of us when catering your next event. Check us out online at steaksandwine.com for daily lunch specials and details on upcoming wine tastings and fun events.
Late Mark Garage, located on Highway 280 in Jackson's Gap, has been serving our area since 1993. From routine maintenance such as oil changes, tune-ups, and rotating and balancing your tires, to transmission and engine repair, our trained and certified mechanics will get you back on the road better than before. Need a tow? With a 24-hour, 7-day-a-week towing service, Late Mark Garage has local and long-range pickup. Trust your vehicle needs to the professionals at Late Mark Garage. Call 256-825-6139, or better yet, stop in and see them today. Late Mark Garage.
What's the verdict?
Can't fix your heat pump. Need a new one.
Uh-oh. What are you thinking?
I'm thinking Daikin.
Call on Kevin Kill and Sunshine Heating and Air at 256-825-4849, Central Alabama's premier Daikin dealer.
So what's he thinking?
Oh, he's thinking Daikin.
Daikin, one of the top selling in the world.
Now I'm thinking Daikin.
Daikin, comfort for life.
Passion, the obsession that burns within. Determination, the burning desire to make it. Drive, the motivation to be the absolute best. Skills, the tools to perform at the highest level. Excellence, the feeling of achievement. At Central Alabama Community College, you can release your passion, show your determination, display your drive, and showcase your skills to achieve excellence. Central Alabama Community College, central to you, central to your success.
There's only one option for top-of-the-line aftermarket upgrades on your vehicle, and that's Frontline Outfitters. We offer quality parts, lift kits, custom wheels and tires, bed covers, step bars, and toolboxes. They're installed by trained and skilled professionals to custom powder coating with hundreds of colors and finishes to the highest quality film for window tinting using state-of-the-art film cutting technology. Call Frontline Outfitters at 256-409-8100. Don't be in the back of the line. Put your vehicle at the front with Frontline Outfitters.
Grain and Leaf, located at 6068 Highway 63 South, is Lake Martin's premier boutique-style bottle shop with a unique array of sophistication for everyone. Appropriately named for its exclusive selection of top spirits, wine, and craft beer, Grain and Leaf also has a number of fine cigars for you to choose from. They also carry the full line of Hornsby Farms assorted jellies and pottery. Open 10 to 7 Monday through Saturday and noon to 5 on Sundays, Grain and Leaf is your premier shop in the Lake Martin area.
Lake Martin Mobile Detailing is the number one auto and boat detailing company in Central Alabama. Don't trust your boat or vehicle to just anybody. Hire the professionals. Top-of-the-line ceramic coating, detailing, gel coat restoration, and paint correction gives you the options to take care of your vehicle the right way. Located at 702 McCarty Road in Dable, Lake Martin Mobile Detailing will have you riding in style. Call them today at 256-794-2328 for Superior Automotive and Boat Detailing.
J.A. Smith Construction is your trusted choice for construction site clearing and grading for new home construction, underground utilities and site work, concrete paving, storm drain installation, fish ponds, and slough dredging. No job is too big or too small. Call Alexander at J.A. Smith Construction at 256-896-1400 or email asmith@jasmithconstruct.com. J.A. Smith Construction, your trusted choice for construction.
Registration for the 41st Alabama State Games is now open at allagames.com. Join us as we return to Birmingham for an exciting 3 days of Olympic-styled action June 7th through 9th. There are 24 sports offered and $40,000 in scholarships up for grabs. The Alabama State Games brings a mix of individual and team sports for all ages and abilities so everyone can go for the gold. Don't let this opportunity pass you by. Registration and event info can be found at allagames.com.
Welcome back, everyone, to the Auburn Blitz. Halfway through our program, we'll have Jason Caldwell in the next segment, so stay tuned there. Got a lot to talk to with Jason. Got football spring practice going on. Got baseball we'll be discussing, and, of course, to get his take on Auburn's matchup here with Yale coming up this afternoon. Let's go back to the Mortgage Pro Eric McKinley Hotline and welcome in our good buddy Terry. What's up, Terry?
Hey, brother Scott. How y'all doing?
We're good, brother.
You?
Fantastic. I want to ask y'all a question. I'll play a little bit later on. I'm a little late calling in, but I'm getting into it. So have they fired Calipari, by the way?
Not yet. Yeah, they ain't backed up the Brinks truck to his door yet. So.
Yeah, he may get, what, $30, $35 million or so to leave?
Yeah, I think so.
Kind of hard for me to have sympathy for a guy getting $35
million. Nah, I don't have sympathy for him.
No.
I just wondered about, you're going to have Jason on the next segment?
Right.
Okay. I'm curious about spring training, how's it going? Because I'm not a big fan of the break to go on spring break and then come back and finish. I'm not a big fan of that, especially when you're trying to establish camaraderie amongst the teammates. That break, I don't like it. I've never been a fan of that. I'd like you to ask him how that's working out and everything.
Well, everything we've been told and hearing is everything's going great in spring. They're having a great spring. They got 7 practices under their belt. They're halfway through the spring. I think different strokes for different folks. I'm with you kind of, Terry, from an old school mentality. Once you start something, get rolling, you take a break right out of the gate. But it doesn't seem to have disrupted anything that they're doing. I definitely will talk to Jason about that and see. But all the reports are, man, a lot of young guys making strides, moving up, a lot of superlatives. Cam Coleman running specifically with the ones now. Hearing a lot about Malik Blockton and some of those guys on the defensive line. So I'm just hearing a lot of positive things right now.
How much pressure do you guys think is on Peyton Thorne next year? Because, like I said, the guy's got all the weapons. He's got a year in the system now. There's no more excuses. If he wants to rush in a Nebraska offense for 100 yards a game, then go somewhere else.
He's going to have a short leash, in my opinion. I think Walker White has moved up primarily running with the twos. From what we're being told, and I'm not surprised by that. He's got all the tools, and he picks up on this offense. I think he is right on the heels of Peyton Thorne right now. So I think Peyton Thorne understands that. He's number one right now because he was the quarterback last year. So I think we'll see Walker White challenge for that job for sure.
He's got one of the things I think is one of the most overrated things, sometimes one of the most overrated things in football, and that's experience. I realize it's important, and I realize it's necessary, but sometimes I think it can be overrated because when you're just not any good, you're just not any good. I think at times last year, Peyton Thorne just wasn't any good.
It was several games. The best game he had was against Arkansas.
Right.
But then we found out how bad Arkansas really was.
Yeah, exactly. His best game was against Arkansas, not a very good football team, let's be honest.
Right. No doubt.
Take care, guys.
All right, thanks, Terry. Appreciate your call, man. Hey, look, I'll add something to that. I've told all of y'all this. I feel like Walker White, just by watching the film and his maturity, and when Auburn signed him, his press conference, this kid's built different.
Mm-hmm.
He's number 7 quarterback in the country for a reason.
Mm-hmm.
He's already got the physical. He looks the part. Very, very football savvy mind-wise. Here's the deal. Everybody was on an even playing field here, Scott, because this is a new coaching staff.
Right.
So Peyton Thorne, all that last year is gone.
Right.
You know, Philip Montgomery's not there anymore.
Right.
A whole different staff basically on the offensive side. So nobody's really got a leg up on anybody. You got a lot of newcomers in there. So they're all really at ground zero working their way up. I just like Walker White. Now, again, in this conference, is it tough to start a freshman? Yeah. But Bo Nix was freshman All-SEC, freshman of the year, and – I think – did he win 9 games his first year?
I think he did, but White just oozes confidence, too.
He does.
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah.
And Bo Nix did, too.
Right.
And it takes a guy like that. Everybody's not cut the same way.
Right.
So, and I agree with Terry. Just because you played for 3 or 4 years doesn't mean you're the best.
You're going to be the quarterback's the leader, basically, of the team.
Right. Does he not feel like a natural-born, built-in leader?
Right.
Everybody already kind of looks up to him a little bit.
Right. He'll own the locker room. He'll own a group practice meeting. He'll own all that.
Right.
It'll be him.
Well, you got to have a strong quarterback in that sense if you want to be good. I mean, if you want to compete for championships. Ty said Auburn's pitching looked good last night, but the hitting let them down. Well, hitting's going to let a lot of people down with the guy Arkansas ran out there yesterday. Mm-hmm. Now, again, Auburn had a couple opportunities in that game. In the sixth inning, bases loaded. They couldn't get a key hit. There was another time they had second and third, I believe, with either one out. Couldn't get the runs home. Arkansas's got the number one pitcher in the country. They got a great staff. They're number one for a reason. It does hurt that Auburn had a chance to get that first game from them and build some confidence coming in. I doubt they play today with all the rain. Right. So that'll be a doubleheader that they're looking at on Saturday. But Auburn's staring down the barrel of an 0-6 start in baseball. We'll get to that with Jason. We'll try to carry over a little bit extra with Jason in the next segment because you've got a lot to discuss and talk about. You know, all a bunch of stuff going on. You got basketball, the women, we ain't talked about them. They got booted in the first round.
But they're making strides. They're good,
making
they're
huge
better.
Strides. Yeah, I mean, that's the first time they've been back in the tournament since 16.
Right.
So it's been a while. Up against the break, when we come back, we'll have Jason Caldwell from inside the Auburn Tigers and Auburn Undercover with us. Stay tuned. More to come right after this.
Of nurses say they went into the profession because they wanted to help patients. No matter the reason you decided to become a nurse, you have all the tools needed to advance your degree at Jacksonville State University. Our Master's in Nursing program is now offered fully online and can be completed in less than 2 years. You can customize a flexible course schedule so you can receive your advanced education degree all while working on the front lines. JSU Nursing, your opportunity to advance your career and serve your community.
Egg rolls are back at Zaxby's. They're hand-rolled and come with a delicious sweet and spicy dipping sauce.
But enough from me. Let the egg rolls do the talking. And there you have it. $2 for $3 egg rolls. Woo! Saucy! Zaxby's.
At C&T Electric, our clients are our priority. For the safety and security of your family and home, our technicians are professionally trained, drug tested, background checked, and wear uniforms with name tags. We're proud to have served the Elk City, Dadeville, and Lake Martin areas for the past 10 years. Give us a call at 256-234-0007 for all your electrical service and repair needs. Or visit us on the web at www.cntelectricllc.com and spell out the word AND.
WOTM is the television provider for all Alabama High School Athletic Association championship events and special programs. WOTM is your home for the Super 7 football, state finals basketball, baseball and softball state championships, the AHSAA weekly show, and WOTM also produced the first ever football playoff show, Super 7 preview show, and reclassification reveal show. Your exclusive home for all things AHSAA is WOTM. Contact your local cable provider to request WOTM to your channel lineup.
Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply Stores have the tools and materials to get the job done right, whether you're a professional contractor or just a weekend do-it-yourselfer. With everyday customer conveniences like a drive-through lumber yard, price match promise, and our best rewards program, each of our 9 locations offer top brands and building materials like lumber, hardware, tools, paint, lawn and garden, and much more. Visit today and see what Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply can help you build tomorrow.
Bucks Island is your boating headquarters. Are you ready to hit the water and go boating this summer? Bucks Island has all kinds of boats, with one sure to fit exactly what you want. Fishing boats, sport boats, pontoon boats, and all with low monthly payments. Call 1-800-I'M-READY. Bucks Island service department experts are also here for you to keep your boat in top running condition. Call 1-800-I'M-READY. Don't be left standing on the bank this summer. Visit online at bucksisland.com. And don't buy a boat till you get a Bucks quote.
Lake Martin Funeral Home and Cremation is coming soon to the corner of 280 and 49 North in Dadeville. This new 10,000 square foot facility is conveniently located to serve the residents of the Lake Martin area and its many communities. A branch of Frederick Dean Funeral Home and Crematory in Opelika, Lake Martin Funeral Home and Cremation looks forward to serving your families and your communities, as we have since 1900 at Frederick Dean. 256-750-0381.
Fried chicken and wontons and teriyaki glaze and an egg roll. Some people think the Zaxby's Sensation Salad is too delicious to be a salad.
Yep, that's why we call it a salad. The Zaxby's Sensation Salad. Zaxby's.
Welcome back, everyone, to the Auburn Blitz. Couple segments left in today's show here on this Friday. Go back to the Eric McKinley Mortgage Pro Hotline. Welcome in our good friend Jason Caldwell from Auburn Undercover. Jason, happy Friday to you. Another rainy Friday out there.
It is. So we've had a few of these. It seems like the past couple of months that waits till a Friday afternoon to start raining. It's pretty wet. Pretty wet. We'll see what it looks like here in a few hours with baseball trying to play game two against Arkansas at 6 o'clock tonight. Not real optimistic about that one, but got a lot of things to happen between now and then on the calendar, so we'll see what happens.
Yeah, we'll start with baseball since you're talking about that. That was a tough one last night. 1-0, Auburn played really well defensively and on the mound. You give up that solo home run in the first inning. Of course, we know what Arkansas ran out there yesterday, maybe the best pitcher in the country. But Auburn had his chances a couple times to scratch a couple of runs across, but just couldn't do it, man. Got a rebound and find a way to get at least one win this weekend, if not maybe try to win this series and get these last two.
Yeah, no, obviously it's very difficult. And, you know, we knew what the schedule was. When you go to Vandy and you have Arkansas next, and then you're at Texas A&M, and then Tennessee after that.
Brutal.
You know it's going to be difficult. And yeah, it's a matter of kind of putting some things together. They had a couple opportunities last night. You're right, Hagan Smith is not quite the same when you think about what you saw last year. You know, at LSU, but lefty. 96, 97 at times last night, really good stuff. And so it was a difficult challenge. And, again, a couple of two-out hits here there is the difference in the game. And Auburn just didn't make them. So we'll see how they respond.
You know, Jason, moving over from baseball to this basketball, you look at this matchup for Auburn, you can't look past anybody. Obviously, we saw that yesterday. And I'll get your thoughts on Kentucky here in just a minute. But just this matchup with Yale, I mean, this is a good defensive team. They got a couple of weapons, and, you know, anything can happen in March.
Yeah, no, we've already seen that. I think the one thing, if you're Auburn, you hold your hat on is veteran presence. I think that's very beneficial. Knowing how you can't take anyone for granted, I think, is a big deal there. So we'll see. I think it's a good matchup for Auburn, but you're right, you never know, because if you don't shoot it well, then nobody's a good matchup. And that's the thing you look at, going, how well do you shoot the basketball? It doesn't turn you over very much, and they don't get to the free throw line a ton. And those are two things that you're talking about Auburn, that's the one thing that's kind of been the bugaboos, is fouling, letting teams shoot a bunch of free throws, and then turnovers at times. So Auburn has been pretty good in the half court. So that's not as bothersome as it has been in the past. But, again, if you go out and don't shoot it well, then you open the door up for anybody. We saw that with Kentucky yesterday. On the flip side, if you have somebody go out and make 8 or 9 threes, then that becomes a challenge. So you have one of those opportunities to go out. And I think early on, I think the first 7-8 minutes of this game is going to be really important for Auburn, because you want to go out and make a team like Yale chase you. And that's not what they want to do. So I think the key for me, I think the four position, I think Jalen Williams and Chaney Johnson have an advantage in this game with quickness and athleticism. I think that's where Auburn can make some difference up today.
I think you're right on that. I think, yep.
Jason, let's talk about the road, and we get to look past. I know the coaches don't. We look past this game. We take care of business. It doesn't get any easier, obviously, either UAB or San Diego State. I picked San Diego State to win that game, but it would be intriguing, obviously, if Auburn ends up playing UAB. But, you know, you look at this path, it's not an easy bracket. It's a Final Four team. It's two Final Four teams in front of you, probably, if you're able to make it to the Sweet 16.
So, it's I think it's easily the most difficult bracket out there, in my opinion. I think it's the most difficult in terms of physicality and defense. A lot of those teams that wound up in the same bracket, when you look at the way these teams play, and that's normally not real good. And so I think there's a lot of similar type teams in this bracket that are they're athletic, that have been playing well and finished well and won conference tournaments. And so, yeah, it's not easy. The travel's not easy. That's the worst part of this, more than the seeding, is having to go across the country in the East region. And if you win, you don't go home. You fly back across the country, get off a plane, practice for a couple of days, and then play what likely would be the number one team in the country. And so if you're Auburn, all you can do is just do what you can do, which is, hey, you got to go take care of business, handle it, and then move on to the next one. I think that's what they've done in the SEC tournament. And if they carry that over this time, then they'll give themselves a chance to go out and compete with anybody.
I don't think they're going to fly back to Auburn. If we win the first two games, I think they're going straight.
Are they going straight to Boston?
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, they don't come home. They would go straight, fly in, and start. Hey, yeah. Even the people that are covering this, Nathan King's there, Justin Perkins, and some of those guys, they've already decided, look, if Auburn wins, you can't fly back to Atlanta on Monday and then fly to Boston on Tuesday. It doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, you just got to go straight.
Even the media people that are out there would not even be able to come home. They would just go straight.
This has been a joke. I mean, this committee, what they did, not just Auburn, but a bunch of teams, is a total joke in how they organized this. And somebody said, well, you know, they're paying Auburn and Alabama back for being in Birmingham last year. Well, that's stupid. If they take that rationale, because the goal is to make money, the NCAA wants to fill up arenas. Well, Auburn's not going to have many people out there. UAB surely is not going to have anybody, and neither is Alabama.
Right.
They try to say this regionality, and regionality only works for a few teams. After that, it doesn't work for anybody at all. And, hey, Auburn got the ultimate gift last year. Auburn was a 9 seed and got to play at home. That shouldn't happen either. Mm-mm. So it's not like it's, oh, and only on this foot. No, Auburn should, as a 9 seed, you shouldn't be playing a home game.
No.
That's not. It wasn't fair to Houston last season. But that's the point. Look, figure it out. And my thing is, why has it got to be so difficult? How about go back to the way it used to be? If you're in the South, you play in Knoxville or Charlotte or Nashville or Atlanta, Tampa, wherever it is, and that's where your regional is. And you know what? If you win that, you stay there. Instead of, let's have the West bracket playing in Charlotte and the East regional playing in Spokane, Washington.
It's stupid. All right, Jason, let's shift over to football. Spring practice about halfway done. Just your thoughts on how it's going, and maybe some guys that are standing out, and then maybe an update on the quarterbacks.
Yeah, I would start a quarterback first. Well, you know, until you start the scrimmage, I don't think we'll learn a whole lot other than, I mean, Peyton Thorne has all the experience. He's tenfold the amount of experience everybody else on this roster has combined at quarterback. And, that's going to put him there for the long haul, in my opinion. Which one of the other guys steps up, that'll be the question. We'll start to maybe learn a little bit more of that, maybe tomorrow when they scrimmage a little bit, but it's going to be August before we learn anything else really in terms of concrete about the quarterback position. But youth and talented youth is the thing, even the newcomer too. You can see a difference on this roster. We talked about it before we went on the air. I had some high school coaches come out and go, well, this team looks different, and it does. But you got a lot of inexperience in the secondary and some other spots that you're going to have to kind of grow up pretty quick. But you look, and this roster looks much better than it has the last couple of years, and that's where you have to be from a starting point.
Well, Jason, good information. Won't be long before A-Day, and then shut it down. Then there'll be another portal window open. So, man, it never stops, buddy. It's something going on constantly in the world of college athletics now. But, hey, appreciate your time as always on Friday. I always look forward to it, brother. Stay dry out there, and we'll talk to you next week.
Sounds good. Appreciate it.
Thank you so much. Jason Caldwell with Inside the Auburn Tigers and Auburn Undercover does it better than anybody. Always glad to have him part of our program here on Fridays. That's going to wrap this segment up. We come back one final segment here on the Auburn Blitz when we return.
When drinking, take a sober ride home, not someone's life. Alabama has a code of the road, and knowing it helps you follow it. This is a message from your Alabama Department of Transportation.
J.A. Smith Construction is your trusted choice for construction site clearing and grading for new home construction, underground utilities and site work, concrete paving, storm drain installation, fish ponds, and slough dredging.
No job is too big or too small. Call Alexander at J.A. Smith Construction at 256-896-1400 or email asmith@jasmithconstruct.com. J.A. Smith Construction, your trusted choice for construction.
SignSource is your local vendor for commercial and residential sign manufacturing and installation. We offer all kinds of lighted and non-lighted signage, from retail signs, LED message centers, event banners, vehicle wraps, the whole spectrum. We also offer service and repair on existing signs, as well as retrofitting to LED or installation of outsourced signage. We have the knowledge necessary to fulfill all of your signage needs in the short or long term. Visit SignSourceNow.com to get started.
EnviroCare is the standard in East Central Alabama for all your pest control and termite needs. EnviroCare exclusively offers Centricon Termite Colony Elimination System that is the industry's most effective termite control to protect your home year-round. The EnviroCare team's service is also the standard for our customers. From eliminating home pests to superior termite control, nobody cares like EnviroCare. Serving Lake Martin and East Central Alabama.
Chick-fil-A is always the best option when you're on the go, but they are also great when it comes to planning your next event, from tailgating to birthday parties to weddings. Call Chick-fil-A Alexander City at 256-289-7955 for catering or order on the Chick-fil-A app. Make sure to choose the Alexander City location and have your catering order ready to go. Nugget trays, mac and cheese trays, fruit trays, cookie trays, gallons of our famous lemonade or tea, and chilled grilled chicken sub sandwiches, and a lot more options. Make it Chick-fil-A Alexander City for your next event.
Folks around these parts have known for a long time that Walls Tire, just a mile past the bridge on Highway 280, is your number one stop for automotive service and repair. At Walls Tire, you'll always find quality service at a fair price on everything from AC, name brand tires, big or small repairs, routine maintenance, towing, and more. When your car or truck needs to run right, there's one place in the area to go, conveniently located and easy to find. Walls Tire, just a mile past the bridge on Highway 280.
Passion, the obsession that burns within. Determination, the burning desire to make it. Drive, the motivation to be the absolute best. Skills, the tools to perform at the highest level. Excellence, the feeling of achievement. At Central Alabama Community College, you can release your passion, show your determination, display your drive, and showcase your skills to achieve excellence. Central Alabama Community College, central to you, central to your success.
Catch a ride, not a buzz.
Hey, can you come get me?
Being buzzed still counts. Alabama has a code of the road, and knowing it helps you follow it. This is a message from your Alabama Department of Transportation.
Welcome back, everyone, to the Auburn Blitz final segment here on the program, brought to you by Russell Do It Center and Building Supply Stores, with 9 locations in Central Alabama for all your building supply needs. Home decor, they got it. They'll take care of you. J.A. Smith Construction and Excavation, they don't like days like today in the construction and excavation business, because you're not getting a lot done in the mud. But call on them for your projects, whether it's commercial or residential, no job too big or too small. In Central Alabama Community College, with 4 locations in Central Alabama, Alexander City, Chillsburg, Prattville, and Talladega, for all your educational needs. If you're going to a 4-year college, you can transfer. If you're going to get a 2-year degree and go to work, they've got your path for you. Looking at games underway right now at Northwestern and FAU in the second half. Northwestern is up by 7, 48-41. Baylor in control over Colgate, no surprise there, 54-38. And now San Diego State and UAB underway. About 6 minutes into that game, San Diego State up by 2, 11-9. So guess what? Up next will be, after that game on that floor, will be Auburn and Yale, the game we're talking about here on this Friday, Scott. And, you know, again, to kind of give everybody an update, had a on the baseball situation. Softball is in Texas. We'll play Texas A&M, number 12 team in the country. Their bats are cold. Their pitching's great. The bats are cold, so they got to figure that out if they want to stay competitive in league play. And baseball probably will be rained out today. Looks like maybe a doubleheader tomorrow if things don't change. And then Auburn's got to figure out a way to win one of these games, Scott. They can't go 0-6, man.
Nope.
Had a chance last night to get that one.
It's hard to lose. If you go 0-6 and lose a 1-0 in there, that bites a little bit.
Yeah.
Maybe we can get this one in tonight.
I had a comment here. Said, do you think Vanderbilt will go after Bucky McMillan? You know, we talked about this Tuesday night, me and Luke did, and had the same question. I think there may be some things that go with Bucky that may not allow them to do that. I'm not going to go into that. I'm not saying anything derogatory about Bucky McMillan. He's a great coach, obviously, and Sanford would love to keep him. But moving forward, there's some credential things, and when you go to some plays, obviously it was okay for Sanford, but it may not be everywhere else. So I don't know. He's going to be he's a great coach, and I think he's an up-and-comer, and I think there's going to be some people take a shot at him for sure. But we'll just kind of have to see how all that plays out. Other games on tap today, Western Kentucky and Marquette. Stetson will take on UConn. New Mexico and Clemson. Colorado and Florida. Colorado was in that play-in game. Florida, without their big guy inside, suffered that gruesome leg injury against us in the SEC. Championship game, how will that affect Florida? We'll wait and see. A&M will take on a Nebraska team. That's a 9-8 matchup there. A&M is favored by 1.5 in that game. Vermont will take on Duke later on tonight. Grambling and Purdue. I know Purdue still remembers Fairleigh Dickinson from last year. So you don't take anybody for granted. Although Purdue's a 26.5-point favorite.
Is that all?
That's it. Alabama will go on the floor at 6:35. That game will be on True TV against Charleston. Alabama 9.5-point favorite in that game. Number one seed Houston will take on Longwood. Houston is a 23.5-point favorite there. James Madison will take on Wisconsin. That 12-5 matchup's always a rough one. We've already seen that happen in the tournament. James Madison's 31-3 in a 12 seed.
Wow.
So they take on Wisconsin, who's 22-13. Wisconsin's a 5.5-point favorite in that game. Another 9-8 is TCU, Utah State. And Grand Canyon will take on St. Mary's at 9:05. That'll be your eyes rolling, getting heavy, rolling in the back of your head game tonight.
I probably won't make that one.
Probably won't be seeing Grand Canyon and St. Mary's. But Scott, Yale and Auburn here in just a few hours.
We're going to Yale Auburn. That's what we're going to do.
That's what we're going to do.
Yeah.
We're
going to Yale War Eagle.
Yeah. Lyles wanted to know, assume we win, what time we play our next game. It's not determined yet.
No.
We don't even have it listed. So let's concentrate on this game here. And then we'll worry about that coming down the stretch. Look, I said this on Gary Harris's show this morning. Auburn's last two tournament appearances haven't been real pretty. 2 years ago, they got ousted by Miami in that game, and then they turned around last year and got ousted by Houston. So they've made it to the round of 32 the last couple of years, but haven't played really good basketball. I mean, it's a good. I went to the Iowa game last year.
Mm-hmm.
Did you go to that game?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, went to the Iowa game in Birmingham, and you know, I thought Trey Donaldson played really well, and but going into that Houston game, we had a chance,
right?
And then we went on about an 8-minute drought in the second half, and that killed us. This does feel like that 19 team a little bit. It's not the same structured team,
not at all.
But if they can ride this momentum. Yeah, that was a tough run then. Dadgum Kansas, North Carolina, and Kentucky, back to back, and then you play Virginia in the Final Four.
I know it was fun. The only thing is, you know, you get on social media, and everything is just Auburn hyped right now because I guess we're Auburn fans, and we click on Auburn, so everything Auburn comes on your phone.
Right, of course.
I'm like, y'all just need to settle down and just, you know, what if this? No, not what if. We got to win today. And then we discuss Sunday.
Well, again, it goes back to what Bruce said.
Yeah.
Your national championship bid starts today,
right?
Not when you get to the Final Four.
Right.
Because if you don't win today, there is no tomorrow.
That's right. Got to win today.
So, Auburn 315 TNT. Make sure you tune it in. It's raining outside. It's a good day to be watching the March Madness NCAA tournament. It's going to wrap it up for this Friday edition of the Auburn Blitz. Again, I want to thank everybody for joining us each and every day. We'll be back with you again on Monday for another edition. Hopefully, a very successful weekend for the Auburn men's basketball team. We'll be talking about them heading to the Sweet 16, I hope. Right. For Scott Blake, I'm Brett Pritchard saying we've enjoyed it. We hope you have. See you next time.
War Eagle.